Can a woman be charged for the offence of rape? So it again raises the question whether a woman can commit the offence of rape. Scientifically, you may say it is not possible, but the answer is in the affirmative for both of these questions, but only in the eyes of law. I am Mr. Thiruvarathne from the intermediate year of Sri Lanka Law College. In this video clip, I am going to discuss the legal framework pertaining to the offence of rape in Sri Lanka. It is important not only to law students but also to the general public as well. This discussion involves a comparative analysis between the repealed section pertaining to the offence of rape and the substituted section thereto, and to answer the question whether a woman can be charged for the offence of rape. The desired outcomes of this video clip are to make you understand the law pertaining to rape and to make you prepared to provide an appropriate answer at the examination. It was a past question to do a comparative analysis between the sections and to answer the question whether a woman can be charged for the offence of rape. Anyway, I am not going to discuss case laws here since your notes are subject to amendment every year by your lecturer. So let's move on to our analysis first. To do the analysis, you need to have your penal codes with you. Now I want you to have a look at the repealed section 363. I am not going to discuss all the limbs of this section 363. You read them yourself, but have a look at the fifth limb. It says with or without her consent when she is under 12 years of age. Now have a look at the amended section in Act number 22 of 1995 of your Penal Code. In that section 363 limb E, it says with or without her consent when she is under 16 years of age. This means that even if you are having sexual intercourse with the girl who is under 16 years of age, even with her consent, that amounts to rape. Now have a look at the explanation 2 of the substituted section. It says evidence of resistance such as physical injuries to the body is not essential to prove that sexual intercourse took without consent. Now this is a vital element caught up in this new section. Under the previous section, that is the repealed section, there was no such explanation, no such element. So in the cases decided under the repealed section, it required to prove that evidence of resistance is there so as to say that sexual intercourse took place without consent. Have a look at explanation 1 of this substituted section. It says penetration is sufficient to constitute the sexual intercourse necessary to the offence of rape. I must say that to constitute the offence of rape, there must be sexual intercourse. If there is no sexual intercourse, that does not amount to the offence of rape. Now you may have the question, what is the difference between the term sufficient and the term necessary? For example, to enter into a state university in Sri Lanka, a student must pass the advanced level examination. That is a necessary requirement, but that is not sufficient. In addition to passing the examination, that is the A level, the student must get the or obtain the required IZ score. So that is what these two terms, sufficient and necessary, mean. Now have a look at repealed section 364 of your Penal Code. According to this section, the punishment is a term which may extend to 20 years of imprisonment and shall also be liable to fine. Now have a look at the substituted section 364 subsection 1. It states whoever commits rape shall be punished with rigorous imprisonment for a term not less than 7 years and not exceeding 20 years and with fine, and shall in addition be ordered to pay compensation. So rigorous imprisonment is introduced by this section, and also a minimum mandatory sentence, that is minimum 7 years is imposed, and also the offender shall be ordered to pay compensation. Now I want you to have a look at section 364 subsection 2. Here aggravated circumstances are introduced. These aggravated circumstances are listed out from limb A to limb G in section 364 subsection 2. So the punishment for these circumstances are rigorous imprisonment for a term not less than 10 years and not exceeding 20, and in addition shall be ordered to pay compensation. So you see in the proviso that the court is given a discretion when a boy who is under 18 years commits sexual intercourse on a girl who is under 16 years with consent. So in this proviso, there is no minimum mandatory sentence. Now we are going to answer the question whether a woman can commit the offense of rape and whether a woman can be punished with the punishment provided for the offense of rape. To answer this question, I am going to take three hypothetical situations with reference to penal code provisions. So I am taking person W as a woman, persons B and C as men, and person X as subject of rape. Now I want you to have a look at section 364 subsection 2 explanation 1. It says where the offense of rape is committed by one or more persons in a group of persons, each person in such group committing or abetting the commission of such offense is deemed to have committed gang rape. So now suppose that persons B and C, that is these two men, commits rape on person X, that is a woman, and during this process person W, who is the woman, provides water for persons B and C as they are tired in this process. So that amounts to an act of abetment. So according to this explanation, person W, who is the woman, is deemed to have committed gang rape. Therefore the woman is subject to the punishment provided in section 364 subsection 2. So it is evident that a woman can also commit the offense of rape according to this explanation to this section. Now I am going to take two instances where a woman can be punished with the punishment provided for the offense of rape with reference to another two sections. I want you to have a look at section 100, that is abetment. And for your easy understanding, I am going to take a hypothetical situation which concurs with explanation 3 to the section 100. According to explanation 3 of this section 100, it states whoever, either prior to or at the time of the commission of an act, does anything in order to facilitate the commission of that act and thereby facilitates the commission thereof, is said to aid the doing of that act. Suppose that person B is committing rape on person X at a hotel room. Prior to the commission of this act, person W arranges a hotel room or books a hotel room for person B and also arranges a taxi to transport person X to this hotel room. According to explanation 3 of this section 100, it is an act which facilitates the commission of that act, and therefore person W is said to aid the doing of that act. So the punishment if that act abetted is committed is set out in section 102. So according to section 102, whoever abets any offense shall, if the act abetted is committed in consequence of the abetment, be punished with the punishment provided for the offense. So this means that person W, who is the woman who booked the hotel room and arranged the transportation, shall be punished with the punishment provided for the offense of rape. So there you can see that person W or the woman can be punished with the punishment provided for the offense of rape. And now I am going to take another instance where a woman can be punished with the punishment provided for the offense of rape. For this purpose, I want you to have a look at section 113A, that is section relating to conspiracy. So suppose that person W, that is the woman, conspires with person B over the phone to commit rape on person X. And after this conversation over the phone, person B commits rape on person X. According to section 113B, if two or more persons are guilty of the offense of conspiracy for the commission or abetment of any offense, each of them shall be punished in the same manner as if he had abetted such offense. So according to section 113B, if the abetted act is committed, that is rape, if rape is committed, we have to again resort to section 102. So according to section 102, the act abetted is committed now. So the person W shall be punished with the punishment provided for the offense of rape, as she is guilty of abetting the offense of rape by conspiracy. Now I want you to have a careful reading of section 102. According to this section, whoever abets any offense shall, if the act abetted is committed in consequence of the abetment, and no express provision is made by this court for the punishment of such abetment. So now the question arises whether the reasoning we did in the last two hypothetical situations can be related to section 102, because now there's express provision is made by section 364 subsection 2 limb G read with explanation 1. According to this explanation 1, express provision is made for such kind of abetment. So person W, even though she is not present in the last hypothetical situations, one may raise the argument that person W and B constitute a group according to explanation 1, and therefore person W is deemed to have committed gang rape in view of explanation 1, and therefore relying on section 102 is not necessary. For this purpose, I want you to have a look at the case Sajiva Elias Ukkua and others versus the Attorney General. In this case, it states the present law makes provisions not only to enhance the punishment for the offense, but more importantly, to make members of a group liable when the offense of rape or abetment of rape is committed by one or more members of such group. So if we go by this definition, we can say that person W who abets person B is also deemed to have committed gang rape. Further, in this case, it mentions the necessary ingredients of explanation 1 to section 364 subsection 2. It states that there are three ingredients in this explanation 1. The first one is assembly of a group of persons, and then rape committed by one or more persons of such group, and the third element is some members in such group abetting the commission of rape. So now here it states assembly of a group of persons. So we can say that person W, in last two hypothetical situations, even though not physically present, they constitute an assembly of a group with person B. Also, it states in this case that section 363 of our penal code is identical with section 376 subsection 2 limb G of the Indian Penal Code, and it is taken from Indian Penal Code. So in the Indian Penal Code, explanation 1 to section 376 subsection 2 limb G is where a woman is raped by one or more in a group of persons acting in furtherance of their common intention, each of the persons shall be deemed to have committed gang rape within the meaning of this subsection. So now we can say, if this explanation 1 is identical with our explanation 1, and if our explanation 1 is taken from Indian Penal Code's explanation 1, we can say that person W in our last two hypothetical situations who abets is also deemed to have committed gang rape, because the motive of this section is to punish someone who commits or who abets another person who commits rape. And bearing these things in our mind, if we go back again to section 102, it states, whoever abets the offense, if no express provision is made by this code for the punishment of such abetment. So we can clearly see that express provision is made by the Act No. 22 of 1995. So there's a doubt whether we can rely on section 102 in the last two hypothetical situations. So it is proper to say that we can rely on section 102 in last two hypothetical situations if there is no such explanation as explanation 1 to section 364 subsection 2 limb G. So therefore, reading case law is necessary as each case depends on its own circumstances. So now we discussed whether a woman can commit the offense of rape and whether a woman can be punished with the punishment for the offense of rape, and whether that reasoning is correct or whether that reasoning can be supported. In concluding this video clip, I must say that we made an attempt to do a comparative analysis between these sections, and then we answered the question whether a woman can commit the offense of rape. So if you have any questions on this lesson, please write them down in the comment section below instead of sending emails. Thank you.